Hello students, in this video I am going to explain you about the concept of the chromosomal theory of inheritance, linkage, recombination, distance between genes and other tricks related to problems of linkage, other tricks to solve the problems of linkage faster. So actually Mendel proposed that characters are controlled by genes or unit factors. And next, after Mendel, two scientists, Sutton and Bowery, said that they proposed that these genes or unit factors are present on chromosomes. So they also proposed that chromosomes are the carriers of genes and they segregate and assort independently during transmission from one generation to the next generation. So chromosomes are the carriers. So let's say this is a chromosome. On this chromosome genes are present like this. So actually Mendel proposed that characters are controlled by genes or unit factors. And then after Mendel, Sutton and Bowery proposed that these genes or unit factors are present on chromosomes. So chromosomes are the carriers of genes and they get segregated from one another during meiosis and they assort independently during transmission from one generation to the next generation, that is during the formation of gametes through meiosis. Okay, now let's see some similarities between genes and chromosomes discovered by Sutton and Bowery, explained by Sutton and Bowery. So according to Sutton and Bowery, there are similarities between genes and chromosomes. Those similarities are, first one is, both Mendelian factors or genes as well as chromosomes occur in paired condition or paired form, that is diploid condition. So paired condition is nothing but, suppose let's say this is a chromosome and this is another homologous chromosome. So if one allele A is present over here, another allele A, capital A or small a, can be present on its homologous chromosome. So both Mendelian factors are genes as well as chromosomes. So these are genes and these are chromosomes. Chromosomes are in the form of homologous chromosomes and genes are in the form of homozygous alleles or heterozygous alleles. Okay, so both Mendelian factors or genes as well as chromosomes occur in paired form, that is in diploid condition, that is in diploid organisms. Next similarity is gametes. In case of gametes, out of a pair, one unit factor is present, and out of a pair, one unit factor. Suppose these are a pair of alleles. Among these pair of alleles, one gamete carries only one allele. So out of a pair, only one unit factor is present in gamete. Next, coming to chromosomes. So out of a pair of homologous chromosomes, only one chromosome is present in the gamete. That means this chromosome will be transmitted to one gamete and this chromosome will be transmitted to another gamete during meiosis. They get segregated and transmitted to two different gametes. So a gamete consists of only one allele out of a pair of alleles or unit factors, and even chromosomes. Among homologous chromosomes also, only one chromosome is present out of a pair of homologous chromosomes. Okay, next. Third similarity is, after fertilization, paired condition is restored for alleles or unit factors and chromosomes also. So after fertilization, that means, let's say this is male gamete carrying capital A present on a chromosome, and this is female gamete carrying small a on a chromosome. So when both of them fertilize together, what happens? Zygote will be formed. So this zygote consists of both the homologous chromosomes and both the alleles of a gene. So after fertilization, paired condition is restored for alleles or unit factors and chromosomes. Okay, so these are the similarities between genes and chromosomes. So based on these similarities, Sutton and Bowery proposed chromosomal theory of inheritance. So chromosomes are the carriers of genes and these chromosomes segregate independently during the formation of gametes or during meiosis, and they assort independently from one generation to another generation, from one another. Okay, but the experimental, so this chromosomal theory of inheritance is proposed by Sutton and Bowery, but experimental proof for this chromosomal theory of inheritance is given by Morgan. So Morgan conducted experiments on fruit fly, that is Drosophila melanogaster, and he gave experimental proof for this chromosomal theory of inheritance. So fruit fly is also called as mango fly or banana fly, because in these fruits, in mango and banana trees, yeast, actually auxin concentration is high. As auxin concentration is high, yeast grow, yeast cells, that is unicellular fungus, yeast cells grow, and these yeast cells are feeded upon by fruit fly. So yeast cells become prey for this fruit fly. So these fruit flies grow more on banana and mango trees. This fruit fly is also called as jackpot of genetics, because by conducting many experiments on Drosophila melanogaster, Morgan gave some important concepts related to genetics. So this Drosophila melanogaster is also called as jackpot of genetics, and Morgan is the father of experimental genetics. Father of genetics is Gregor John Mendel, but father of experimental genetics is Morgan. And he is also called as fly man of genetics, because he conducted many experiments on Drosophila melanogaster or fruit fly and gave many important concepts related to genetics. Now let's study linkage. Linkage. What is linkage? So let's say this is a chromosome. On this chromosome, genes are present, are arranged like this. So genes present on same chromosome are linked genes. These are called linked genes, because genes present on the same chromosome have physical association between them. So this physical association between genes present on the same chromosome is called linkage. So these linked genes which are present on a chromosome have tendency to stay together because they are linked. So tendency to stay together during transmission from one generation to the another. So these are a pair of homologous chromosomes. I am drawing only one chromatid for each chromosome. And in this pair of homologous chromosomes, like this, genes are present, let's say A, B, C, D, and their alleles. Small a, small b, or capital C, small d, like this. Alleles are present. So during meiosis, what happens? They get segregated and they are transmitted to gametes. So this chromosome will be transmitted to one gamete, or the allele, this allele of a gene, of a D gene, will be transmitted to one gamete. And this allele present on this chromosome will be transmitted to another gamete. So linked genes have tendency to stay together during transmission from one generation to another generation. All these genes present on a chromosome are linked. So all these genes together, they get transmitted to gamete. That means this gamete will carry capital A, capital B, capital C, capital D, and this gamete will carry small a, small b, capital C, small d. Like this, all these genes stay together. They have tendency to stay together during transmission from one generation to the another generation. This phenomena is called as linkage, or the physical association between genes present on the same chromosome is also called as linkage. So for the first time, this linkage was observed, and they talked about linkage. Bateson and Pinnett talked about linkage when they were conducting experiments on sweet pea, that is Lathyrus odoratus. But the mechanism of linkage is explained by Morgan by conducting experiments on fruit fly, that is Drosophila melanogaster. Okay, now let's study tricks and concept of linkage. Tricks and concepts related to linkage groups and types of linkage. So now, what are linkage groups? Linkage groups are nothing but All the genes present on the same chromosome together, they form one linkage group. So as the genes present on the chromosome, on one chromosome, have tendency to transfer together from one generation to another generation, they are forming a group on a chromosome. So this is called as one linkage group. So number of chromosomes present in the haploid condition of an organism is equals to linkage groups. Number of chromosomes present in haploid condition of an organism is equals to linkage group. Pisum. Pisum is nothing but pea plant, that is garden pea, consists of, its diploid chromosomal number is 14 actually, but haploid chromosomal number is 7. So number of linkage groups is equals to 7. In Drosophila, number of linkage groups is equals to 4, because diploid chromosomal number is 8. Next, rice. Diploid chromosomal number is 24. So linkage groups are 12. Humans. In humans, we say 23 linkage groups are present. But coming to female, in female, we say 23 groups only. So actually, what is the diploid chromosomal number of present in female, human female? Diploid chromosomal number is 46. Among 46, 44 are autosomes. These are autosomes. And these two are sex chromosomes, are allosomes. In human female, two allosomes, sex chromosomes, that is XX chromosomes, are present. So haploid chromosomal number is 22, but here X. So 22 plus X, 23 linkage groups. But when coming to male, diploid chromosomal number, here also diploid chromosomal number is 46. Among these 46 chromosomes, 44 are autosomes again, and two are allosomes. But now in human male, these two allosomes are not homologous to each other, because one is X chromosome and the other one is Y chromosome. The type of genes present on X chromosome are not, let's say this is X chromosome, this is Y chromosome. The type of alleles present on X chromosome are not similar with the type of alleles present on Y chromosome. So they are not homologous to each other. As they are non-homologous to each other, so how we consider linkage groups? 22 linkage groups, and then one X chromosome and one Y chromosome. One linkage group present on X chromosome and one linkage group present on Y chromosome. So 22 plus 1 plus 1, 24 linkage groups. Even in Drosophila also, actually diploid chromosomal number is 8. Coming to female, so in case of female, totally 8, na? Among 8, 6 are autosomes, 6 are autosomes, and 2 are allosomes or sex chromosomes. So here sex chromosomes are XX, 6 autosomes, so 6 plus 1, so 6 autosomes. So in haploid chromosomal number, this is 3. So here 3 from autosomes, so 3 plus 1. So what we say, 4 linkage groups in case of female Drosophila. Next, coming to male Drosophila. In case of male Drosophila, right. So 8 chromosomes, diploid chromosomal number is 8. Among 8, 6 are again autosomes. So from these 6 autosomes, 3 are haploid number and 2 are allosomes. Among these 2 allosomes, 1 X chromosome and 1 Y chromosome. So 3 plus 1 plus 1. So totally how many linkage groups? 5 linkage groups. Okay. So this is about the concept of linkage and linkage groups. What is linkage? The physical association between genes present on the same chromosome is linkage. What is linkage group? All the genes present on the same chromosome together are called as one linkage group, because they show the tendency to transfer together from one generation to another generation. Okay, next I'm going to explain you the types of linkage. In the next video, I will explain you the types of linkage. Thank you, students. Hope you understood this concept. Please watch the next video also so that you can understand types of linkage and some tricks related to solve the problems of linkage easily. Thank you, students.